Josh Linkner has a resume that is ridiculously long and successful for someone still hanging around the age of 40. He founded ePrize, of course, which is one of the dominant fixtures in the online promotion business. And now he's with Detroit Venture Partners, a venture capital fund looking to help find the next big thing in Detroit. He's also the author now of Disciplined Dreaming. And great to have the author, entrepreneur, and venture capitalist now, Josh Linkner. As you know, wanted to have this conversation for some time. I'm glad we could finally make it happen.
We're on a mission, a crazy mission, to help rebuild Detroit. Detroit has an enormous creative core. It's deep in our bones, in our DNA. It's part of our soul. We're now in the perfect storm, not of negativity, but of opportunity. And that we're going to have an opportunity right now, right here in the city of Detroit, to do amazing things.
My name is Josh Linkner. I've had the privilege of building 4 high-tech companies over the last 20 years. Most notably is ePrize, the company that we're sitting at today, which has about 350 people and serves 74 of the top 100 brands. I've also authored 2 books, and for the last 30 years, actually, been a jazz musician. I love jazz. It's all about spontaneous creativity and using your imagination to create things on the fly. ePrize is the largest interactive promotion agency in the world. We're kind of like half software company and half ad agency. We're privileged to work with 74 of the top 100 brands, including Coca-Cola, Microsoft, Nike, AT&T, and many, many other brands that you would know. We help those brands connect with their consumers using digital promotions and really a modern day approach to online marketing. I wrote Disciplined Dreaming to make the world a more creative planet. I realized that after the economic catastrophe that we've suffered, we needed a new approach to business. And in fact, the competitive advantages of the past have largely become commoditized. In the new era of business, creativity, original thought, and imagination have become the currency of success. So I wrote the book to help individuals and companies expand their creative capacity and be able to win more in this new highly competitive era of business. And this book is a roadmap that helps you do just that. Disciplined Dreaming offers readers a 5-step process that helps them build, manage, and nurture creativity. I had so much fun interviewing over 200 thought leaders for this book. I interviewed CEOs, billionaires, artists, musicians, nonprofit leaders, and tried to boil all that collective wisdom down into an easy-to-follow system that you can put to work immediately in your own life. Couple examples. I interviewed the folks behind Groupon, and they do some fun things. They randomly move people around their office to create new environments and new perspective. I interviewed one company that wanted to encourage failure. They realized that mistakes are the portals of discovery. So what they did is they issued every employee 2 corporate get out of jail free cards every year. So what they said is go out there, go out on a limb, take risks, and if you really screw something up, just hand us your corporate get out of jail free card. You're off the hook, no questions asked. On the annual reviews, the leaders would actually get upset with people if they didn't use both cards. Is it risky? Sure. You think that company comes up with great ideas? You bet they do. Disciplined Dreaming has a very fun mix of content. There is a framework that allows you to, it's almost like scaffolding, that supports your creative process and allows you to build creative muscle mass. In addition, there's dozens of techniques and tools that allows you to build your creative chops. Things that you can do that are fun, exercises, tools, that allows you, again, to really get going and take your creativity to the next level.
I'm here in downtown Detroit, and I want to let you know that tomorrow there's going to be incredible news, groundbreaking news for Detroit, for creation of jobs, for innovation. Please keep an eye out. I can't give you the secret just yet, but it's going to be big, and I hope that you enjoy the news as much as we do.
Together, we're going to do it. Together, we will create jobs and hope. Together, we will reestablish Detroit as a beacon of innovation and entrepreneurship. Together, we will launch dozens of companies, and in turn, will leave a profound impact on the city. And together, we will play our role in the bigger effort of a new Detroit, Detroit 2.0. So today, we're adding a little bit of magic to our formula. My new partner, Irvin Magic Johnson, has a long history of success, both on and off the court. He has an impeccable reputation and character. He has a shared philosophy and culture, and does business the way we believe, that if you build a culture, you build an environment that empowers people to win, that in turn will drive economic success. He's a Michiganian and cares deeply about Michigan and the city of Detroit. He has a track record for urban revitalization. He brings with him a world-class team and incredible global reach. And of course, that incredible magic touch. So ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege and honor to introduce our new partner, Irvin Magic Johnson.
He's the founder and chairman of ePrize, and he's on a mission to make the world a more creative place. Josh Linkner is best-selling author and of one of the top 10 business books of the year. Josh joins me on the Big Brown Couch. How does that sound? That's cool, right?
You know, it's great to be here. Thank you.
You got a great resume. You've got a great track record for business, but you're also one of the partners in Detroit Venture Partners. And I don't think people really understand what you guys are doing. You've already invested in businesses. Talk about what the Venture Partners are all about. You, Magic Johnson, and Dan Gilbert.
Yeah, Lisa, we're so excited to help try to do our part to rebuild the city of Detroit through entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. So we're investing in seed and early stage technology companies, startups, mm-hmm. with the hope of investing in those companies, and as they flourish and grow, so will our city in turn.
Now we're talking about investing money. So people come to you with business ideas. How many businesses have you invested in since the announcement just a month or so ago?
Well, we started the firm on November 1st, and since then we've looked at 500 deals, mm-hmm. which is such a great thing for us to validate because it shows that there's tremendous amounts of entrepreneurship here in the Detroit region. Mm-hmm. Since that time, we've invested in 8 companies, mm-hmm. and we have 2 more investments that will close in the next 30 days. So we're hoping to invest in 12 to 15 new businesses each year for the duration. And again, if you think about any of those companies taking off to become the next Groupon or Facebook, yeah. that could have a significant impact here in the city of Detroit.
So we're talking about guys, women, people come to you with ideas and you back them with your money. What kind of ideas are we talking about? What can you tell us a couple of the businesses that you've invested in so far?
Sure. Well, I'll tell you, by the way, if you think about watching American Idol, yeah. Where you see some really good stuff and some really funny stuff, it's been quite amusing as well. We see all kinds of fun ideas. But we have an all-digital strategy. Mm-hmm. So investing in things like internet companies, mobile apps, social media, things of that nature. Mm-hmm. And we've invested in some great companies here in the region. One is called Hired My Way, which is a better version of Monster.com. It's a great mm-hmm. way to get employers connected with job seekers.
Really?
And they're doing great, and people right here in the Metro Detroit area are currently getting hired as a result of this site.
Hired My Way. Now, we put a link on our website to Detroit Venture Partners so people can learn more if they have a business idea and they want to get to you guys. They can just link on to our website. Is that as simple as it is? You come with the business idea submitted on online, or how does that work?
Yeah, there's very detailed instructions on our site. We also try to provide some guidance and support for emerging entrepreneurs. Mm-hmm. And it's as simple as filling out some information, and then we can quickly determine if it's a fit for our investment fund.
Very nice, man. Very nice. So I know I'm talking a lot, just throwing a bunch of questions out, but I have a little time with you. This is the book. I read it. It's called Disciplined Dreaming. And where did the idea for this come from? Because there's a lot of great ideas for businesses to think creatively, to become, you know, to monetize things and become better at what they do.
You know, creativity is more important than ever. As we've had a financial crisis and a recession in the last few years, mm-hmm. creativity is the one thing that both companies and individuals need more than ever in order to win. And so I didn't see in the business literature a systematic step-by-step approach to build, nurture, and manage creative capacity. So I wrote the book. Turns out that all of us have enormous creative potential. Mm-hmm. Most of us, though, haven't quite developed those skills. So I wanted to give people a tool to unleash their true creative potential.
You can do this and turn it into cash.
There's no question.
And well, for your business.
Yeah.
And for an individual.
You know, if you think about the businesses that are the most successful, Apple mm-hmm. Computer, Google, these are companies that are exhibiting enormous amounts of creativity. And even for the individual, today you might get hired based on your resume, mm-hmm. but you're going to get promoted and reach your goals and your dreams
right.
based on your ability to create.
Well, we need to talk more. Next time when you come back, we should give people tips from the book on how they can be a little more creative. You up for it?
I'm in.
You're the man. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, the book's called Disciplined Dreaming. For more information on Detroit Venture Partners, we put a link, of course, on our website at myfoxdetroit.com.
Where do you think you'd find the world's hottest interactive promotion company? San Francisco? Try Pleasant Ridge, Michigan, where you'll find ePrize.
Michigan is perfect for us. There's a great talent pool and the right business cost structure. With a ton of support from the Michigan Economic Development Corporation, we're taking full advantage of everything that Michigan has to offer.
Now is the time to bring your entrepreneurial company here, because wherever in the world you compete, Michigan can give you the upper hand.
Let's start a little bit with Detroit. You just got back from a conversation at the White House talking about specifically Detroit, but in general about where the next big ideas and businesses are coming from. How's this venture capital fund that is kind of a new idea in Detroit? Silicon Valley and places like that have done this for years, but kind of new for us here. How's it going so far, and what are you finding?
You know, it's going great. My partners and I are so committed to helping rebuild Detroit through entrepreneurial fire. And we believe, you know, Detroit is on the map originally because of great entrepreneurs and creativity right. and innovation, right. folks like Henry Ford. And unfortunately, over the last several decades, we got away from that. You know, we started focusing on bureaucracies and entitlement and finger pointing. Well, I think we need to get back to those entrepreneurial roots. So what we're doing is we're investing in early stage technology companies. And as they grow, they'll create jobs, urban density, and hope.
In fact, I think some business philosophers would say that that's sort of the natural condition of things. You lose your way with where you originally were, with what really made your bones. But we forget all the time the creative entrepreneur, the power that is inside the auto industry today.
You know, that's exactly right. And the thing is that Silicon Valley and New York and Boston have become powerful hotbeds of innovation and technology, partly because they've had investors and supporters to nurture those early stage companies. Yeah. Here in this region, we have all the right ingredients. We have amazing universities, great talent, terrific technology, driven entrepreneurs. And so we're hoping to provide that connective tissue to provide capital, but also a lot of support and coaching and mentorship to help these companies win and in turn help our city and our state win.
One of the stories that we have heard forever in Detroit is that great ideas get bogged down in too much red tape, too much bureaucratic nonsense with people who really can't quite see maybe the vision that you've got. Are we doing any better at cutting away that red tape and helping people see the finish line?
You know, I think we are. And in fact, you know, I had the privilege of building a technology company here in this region, and it was great shattering conventional wisdom. You know, when someone tells an entrepreneur it can't be done, you know, that fires you up.
It's the best time, right?
But today is a wonderful time to be launching technology companies in Detroit. We have low cost basis, we have talented people, and a lot of that red tape, certainly in the government sector, has been cut through. So I think it's a fertile time to build technology companies.
Venture capital, the idea behind it really boils down to having a vision. And I think sometimes the bureaucratic side of it also has a trouble with that same vision. You know, it took us a long time to break through the food truck blockade because I think a lot of people couldn't quite see how important that was to young people today and what that is in other big cities. That's the other thing. How do we create this vision to get everybody understanding what the future can be?
Well, you know, as I talk about in my book, we all, as human beings, have enormous creative potential. And there's tons of great ideas out there. People have them all the time. So what we need to do together as a community is create an environment that empowers people to go for those ideas, empower responsible risk-taking, providing capital and support.
Responsible risk-taking.
So they can go for it. And I think that's what ultimately will help rebuild this region. You know, the other side of the vision, which is the scary part, is if we don't do something, if we don't recreate a strong urban core, 50% of our college graduates will continue to leave the state. And so our vision is if we can rebuild and create a vibrant downtown tech-based corridor, it's going to not only drive economic value today, but we'll ensure our future because we'll keep our best and brightest here in the state of Michigan.
We're seeing that corridor really start to develop, CompuWare, on and on and on, Quicken, and then on up to the smaller businesses that are now starting to populate Midtown. What are the most exciting things that you're seeing right now? What are the ideas that are really exciting you?
Well, you know, we launched our business on November 1st, Detroit Venture Partners, and it was on the hypothesis that there was great ideas and great entrepreneurs out there. We've looked at 500 deals since that time, since launching.
So it tells you the kind of hunger that there is for people who want to make it.
And by the way, you know, very high quality. And I have Silicon Valley friends and other VCs all over the world, and you know, certainly comparable quality. So there's a lot of great ideas out there. We funded 8 businesses so far. We have 2 under contract now. So we plan to invest in 12 to 15 businesses a year for the duration. And if any of those become the next, you know, Groupon or Facebook, that could really have a transformative impact on our region.
How many of these are web-based, or does everything these days, everything has to have a web presence, obviously, but how many of these are really web-based businesses, kind of like ePrize was?
So we have an all-digital strategy, and every investment that we're making is either web or mobile app or social mm-hmm. media, that kind of thing. And partly because those businesses can grow quickly and attract, you know, vibrant, you know, creative class-type
right.
people,
right.
Also, this is because what we know. And so as a venture capitalist, you want to invest in something that you're going to add value. If it was a medical company, I'd screw it up for sure. And there's great talented VCs that know that business. But technology, we can actually help, and we can help these businesses win.
Do you want to care to tip your hand a little bit on what these kind of, what is the future of, what's the next great app going to do?
Well, you know, we're seeing such amazing things every day. One of the cool companies here right in Metro Detroit that we are backing is a company called Hired My Way, which is putting people back to work through a better job board metaphor. So instead of Monster.com, they've done a better job for both the employer and the job seeker, and people are being hired right now in the metro area today based on this technology.
This is a way of you've got a job, moving your way up the ladder instead of kind of being at the baseline starting over.
Yeah. And if you're looking for a job, it's a better model. It's better for employers to find the right people, yeah. And it's better for job seekers to find the right fit.
Well, I want you to stick around. We're going to head over to the, of course, because it's Josh Linkner, we're going to head over to the website site at clickondetroit.com and continue this conversation. I want to talk a lot more about creativity, because Josh doesn't believe creative people are necessarily born. They can be made. We'll talk about that. Join us over there. Thanks so much for being here on the broadcast side. Meet the Press is coming up next. Have a great week. We'll see you next time on Flashpoint.